Hey, good morning. We were discussing just now in our chat about Zolt cryptocurrency, the process of deployment mobile applications. And I decided to record this short video to explain how small projects like the projects some programmers are contributing right now should be developed. So here's what's happening. A few volunteers decided to create mobile apps for our cryptocurrency. And a few of them created mobile apps which are not complete right now because it's all in development and they just started just a few days ago. And they demonstrated their applications in GitHub repositories saying that I'm using React.js, I'm using Flutter, I'm using something else. Just look at my repo, look at my source code. You can try it yourself. You can install it on your local computer, run it and see how it works. And then I ask all of them, how can I install it on my mobile phone? What can I do in order to run it on iPhone and see that it works? Because that's a mobile app, so I want it to be in my hands in order to test that. And they are saying, all of them, that it's not ready, we don't really know how to deploy, it's not ready for the Apple Store, so maybe we should wait for until it's finally done. We need to put all the features, make the design complete, and then we think about deployment. And I'm telling them, explaining them there, and that's why I'm recording the video, that this is not how software projects should run. The process should look completely different. First of all, you create some skeleton, something which you can create in 1, 2, 3 days to prove yourself that the application actually works and looks like something which will do what it is supposed to do. Then the step number two, after the skeleton is ready, is you deploy that skeleton. You make your application deployable. It shouldn't run on your laptop anymore. It should be something which the world can see. If it's a mobile app, put it on test flight, or I don't know what people are using right now to deploy an incomplete app, which is not yet ready to Apple Store or Google Store, but it's ready for us testers to look at. Test flight or something. Not just deploy it once, but configure the entire deployment pipeline. Make sure that you can click the button and your source code is compiled, packaged, delivered to somewhere, to test flight, for example, where I can fetch it from, installed on my mobile phone and test it. This second step is absolutely important for any application. First, you create the skeleton. Second, you make it deployable. You deploy it and then you demonstrate it to everybody. That's a step number three. You show it to everybody. It may be incomplete. In case of a mobile app, it could be just one screen application which says, click here to log in. I click and it doesn't log in. That's enough. I will see something that, you know, it's something which is testable, which has some design, which has something, but it's not anymore a group of files. It is a packageable application, deliverable to customers. And then at step number four, you continue putting features on your application and deploying it every day or multiple times a day, or maybe once a week. It depends on the amount of features you can add. So first of all, you do something which looks like a skeleton which works. Then you configure the pipeline, make sure it is a package, make sure it's an application visible and usable by users. Then you demonstrate it to your user group, a very small one, and tell them that from now on, starting tomorrow, I'm going to add more features. Stay tuned, watch my progress, and you can reinstall the app on your phones, on your mobile phones, while I'm working on more features. And then you keep working and we keep watching your progress. That's how it should be done. Don't wait until your software, until your app is fully ready. Don't do that. Make sure it's deployable from the first day, from the second day of your project. That's what I wanted to say. Thanks for listening. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.